Hi friends, TK Kundu from FTH Desk with a brief description of clause in English grammar. Guys, I have already discussed about clause in details earlier. Again, I want to discuss it in brief for the convenience of the student friends because often they are confused about it. So let me discuss it very briefly. Listen to me. A clause is a group of words. It has a subject and a finite verb. It is a part of sentence. Example, as I am suffering from fever, I cannot go to school. In this sentence, there are two clauses. Number one, as I am suffering from fever, it does not give us independent meaning. It is dependent clause or subordinate clause. Number two, I cannot go to school. It gives us meaning independently. It is independent clause or principal clause. There is another clause and it is called coordinate clause. In this clause, two independent clauses are linked by a coordinating conjunction like and, but, etc. Example, the student is intelligent and I know him. Here the two sentences are coordinating to each other and are connected by the coordinating conjunction and. Subordinate clauses are of three types. Number one, noun or nominal clause. Number two, adjective or relative clause. And number three, adverbial clause. Noun clause. That Ram is a good boy is known to me, or I know that Ram is a good boy, or it is known to me that Ram is a good boy. In all the cases, that Ram is a good boy is noun clause. In first sentence, it is used as a subject. In second sentence, it is used as an object. And in third sentence, it is used as a complement of the verb. Sometimes noun clause is used as an object of a preposition. Example, listen to what your teacher says, or I do not believe in what he says, or I know nothing of what was the original fact. In first sentence, what your teacher says is noun clause. In second sentence, what he says is noun clause. And in third sentence, what was the original fact is noun clause. In all the cases, it is used as an object of a preposition. Relative clause. Relative clause does the function of an adjective and so its other name is adjective clause. The clause expands the meaning of a noun or a pronoun which is called antecedent. In this clause, relative pronouns like who, which, that, whom, whose, etc. and relative adverbs like when, where, how, why, where, etc. are used. Examples. Number one, I know Ram, who is a good boy. Number two, this is my pen, which is green in color. Number three, the person whom you saw yesterday is my uncle. In first sentence, Ram is antecedent, means previous word. Who is relative pronoun and who is a good boy is relative clause. In second sentence, pain is antecedent, means previous word. Which is relative pronoun and which is green in color is relative clause. In third sentence, person is antecedent, means previous word. Whom is relative pronoun and whom you saw yesterday is relative clause. Adverbial clause. Adverbial clause does the function of an adverb. In adverbial clause, when, while, after, before, till, until, since, as, because, so that, unless, if, though, although, etc. are used. Examples. 1. The fox disappear when the sun rises. Number 2. If you come, I'll go to book fair with you. Number 3. I could not go to school yesterday because I was ill. Number 4. Though he was not fully prepared, he performed well in the examination. Number 5. As it was raining heavily, I could not attend the function. All are the sentences with adverbial clause. In first sentence, when the sun rises is adverbial clause. In second sentence, if you come is adverbial clause. In third sentence, because I was ill is adverbial clause. In fourth sentence, though he was not fully prepared is adverbial clause. In fifth sentence, as it was raining heavily is adverbial clause. So guys, these are the clauses which I have described now very briefly. I hope it's clear to you. Thanks for listening to me, Tata. See you again.